muscles. I mean, it's just extremely lucky.
It really helped your family. I mean, with all of the resources that it sounds like your family ended up having, was it our government that helped out, do you think?
Oh yeah. Right. I mean, you know, Kerry got involved, and his chief of staff was a real go-getter. You know, the whole saying, you only pray to God when you need him. Well, this was needing him, you know, 24 hours a day, basically.
Do you think?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, Kerry got involved, and his chief of staff was a real go-getter.
Pretty cramped. Would you say hundreds of people are in jail by the, you know?
That's very important. These guys, I kept trying to ask that, like, how many political prisoners do you think they have? How many jails are there in Tripoli? And he's like, we think there's between 10 and 11 jails. Women told me they prayed the rosary for me, and they had other people staying up praying the rosary. Unbelievable, from a town that guys showing electrical burns, you know, like a doctor from Britain, you know, telling me, you know, I couldn't hear out of this ear, you know, and his jaw was sort of, you know, fractured. From Kingswood Regional in Wolfboro, New Hampshire, folks in Rochester who held prayer vigils for me and came up hugging me and you know, said they prayed for me every night.
Now free from captivity in Libya, James Foley has many thanks to deliver.
You know, Wentworth Douglas Hospital and all those folks, you know, who were holding up like Free Foley signs on the internet.
The biggest thing he wants people to take away from his work as a conflict journalist in Libya are the people in the center.
They want to be able to say, what if I don't like my leader? Could I say that, you know, and not get arrested? Well, not now in Libya. So in this area of Benghazi that was free, it was a tremendous sense of celebration.
He calls Libyans, quote, normal people, forced to live without the liberties citizens have in places like the U.S. Foley says he saw evidence of some political prisoners being tortured. For him, though, the toughest part was witnessing the death of a fellow journalist as he was being captured, a photographer named Anton Hamrill.
They need to recover his body, you know, and we need to put pressure on the regime to recover his body.
Foley calls the first time he was able to call home a pivotal moment.
And it was a sign that they were giving us our basic human rights after a long time. So maybe we were on somebody's radar. You know, maybe there was things starting to work for us.
He clearly remembers what he tried to communicate.
You know, Mom, I've been praying so hard just that you would know that I was okay. I've been praying for that. You know, I hope that she heard in my voice that I was being truthful and that I was like physically, I was strong enough to keep going.